Hey y'all, so I'm doing a quick weave on my client today. I'll be using a growth cream to moisturize her scalp, followed by a glue protectant, a stocking cap, and lastly, an applicator brush. I am starting by applying the growth cream all over her scalp, massaging it in, being careful to not overly apply the product so it doesn't affect the glue protectant or the glue. Okay, so I'm about to apply the glue protective shield. It just basically protects the hair and scalp. I'll be sure to link it below. So basically, you just want to apply this product anywhere glue is going. So in this case, all over, making sure you saturate them edges real good. Making sure you get any little spot you're gonna put some glue on. Okay, so now I'm about to put her under a dryer for about 15 to 20 minutes, just until this product dries completely. And she is dry. As you can see, it kind of like looks shinier. It's kind of like a firm feeling. And we are ready to glue these tracks on. So this is some store-bought hair from a beauty supply store. I honestly love this type of hair for bobs. Like, it's so flowy. Beauty supply store hair is honestly the best for bobs. Okay, so I just sprayed some pump it up on her hair, well, on the cap, and now I'm just gonna be gluing these tracks in piece by piece, track by track, just gluing and cutting and cutting and gluing and gluing and cutting. So I am applying the pump it up before gluing each track, and then I'm also blow drying each glued track to seal the glue afterwards. I just had to edit a lot of that out because this video was getting way too long. Okay, so I will be creating a closure for the top of her head. So I marked where exactly I want the closure to go. And this just makes it so much easier just to ensure the closure is not crooked or out of place. Because, hunty, the worst thing that could ever happen is you finish this up and her closure is on the side of her damn head. Okay, we don't want that. And that's happened to me. So I've just started to mark things just to eye it and to make sure it comes out right. So for this look, we do not want a super thick bang. We just kind of wanted to keep it like natural and cute, kind of like a finer fringe. So this is the reason why I'm just now starting to wrap hair around the front. Okay, so we're just gonna keep wrapping the track around and around and around. Okay, and so all that's left is the little red area that we marked. All right, so now I am creating her closure. So before I put glue on this piece of hair right here, I just went ahead and rolled it without any glue and just fit it in that hole at the top just to make sure it was big enough, small enough, whatever, and it was perfect. So now I'm just rolling it up. Okay, so I'm done rolling the closure. Now I'm just evenly dispersing the hair out on each side, finding the middle of that closure. Now we're gonna heat it up, flatten them tracks out as flat as you can possibly get it, okay? As flat as you can get it, because don't nobody want their weave looking pointy at the top, okay? Put some pump it up in the hole, put some pump it up on the track. I had already put the glue on the track. Now I just spray some pump it up, push that track down into that hole. Well, the closure, push the closure down into the hole real good. Don't rush this process. Make sure it's really in there. And then I went over it with the blow dryer. All right, so now I'm about to start her cut. I'm using my Andis T-liners, a cutting comb, and some shears. I'm going in first and creating a guide that I will follow for the whole haircut. I don't know what happened to the video of me cutting off the band on the stocking cap, but I did it right before this scene right here. It really don't matter when you cut the band off, as long as you cut it off after all the tracks are glued on. So I flat ironed all of the hair. Now I'm finna cut her bang. And yeah. I'm about to cut her bang with a razor. I don't know what happened to my razor holder before cutting this bang. I could not find it, so I just had to go straight in with this razor, but nobody was injured in the process and it worked just fine. I am going in with my thinning shears just a little bit, like here and there. I just decided that some spots needed a little more thinning. My client is so funny. I had to zoom into that part. Love you, Mickey. So this is the final product. She was very happy with the outcome. Thank you guys so much for watching.